sometimes write 1550. So the figure keeps changing. And that is not all. There are other agencies who have community toilets. So how many are those? That is not being listed. Another thing that I find, this is at one level, when I start working at a very community level or at a very local level. But when I also interact with SPA, their School of Planning and Architecture, there I get to hear all these very sophisticated words, which is very, again, interesting. It's called SDI, Spatial Data Infrastructure. And this is fantastic. You know, if I have those information and then I got to know that Delhi has made it, Delhi Spatial Data Infrastructure. But when I visited the website, but I think I should not be very impatient because it has just started. And I'm very sure the information is going to be uploaded there. But right now, there is no information on that. But they have mapped the entire city. They have mapped the entire utilities. It is all there. It is claimed that it is all there. And I'm very sure it's there. But right now, it is not in the public domain. And the debate that is going on, that when I asked the NDMC official, the person who presented before, that I have to be fast. I cannot speak more fast than this. Okay, I can. But that's not fair.
Okay.
Because you just gave me 5 minutes and then you say wind up. And when it comes to other things, then you say, okay, you go on. No, I will not. I have to take at least 5-7 minutes. Because this partial data infrastructure is something that I think is going to be our future. And for the planning, this is going to be a very interesting tool and a very sophisticated tool. But how much information would be in the public domain? And how much information would be available to planners? And how our municipalities are empowered to use this information is something I think that needs to be looked into much more detail. And I would request SPA to really look into it, because right now, it's a kind of, the spatial data is not being used. Like when you say a city has 236 slums, but how many square kilometers of slum is something that is more important to make a policy level decision. Like when I say community toilets, you know, how much of area it is covering and how, where are they located in the city? That is something, the spatial references are more important than just the numbers of it. Jokes apart, I'll finish it quickly. Don't worry. So we are supporting this InScare NGO, whom we supported to carry out a baseline study, where we went, actually I did this, I'm not a GIS person, but I did this effort with a student, that we went to the 80 CTCs and we kind of did the GPS mapping and then tried to map it on a Google map and then started analyzing it spatially. It would be good to have a satellite image, but we cannot afford that right now. So what we thought, we'll use the Google map and then use it there and locate all these things. And what it gives as a interesting thing, you know, the toilets and the density of the area, you can see it. And where are these toilets located is interesting. Like, you know, you can make some analysis out of it. What I require now is a sewage map. If I can overlay with the sewage map of Delhi, then we can make a, you know, kind of a spatial analysis where the sewage map goes and how it goes. So I've been requesting MCD, DJB to share the sewage map, then it would be good for us to do the further analysis. We are trying to make a unique ID for the CTC and then make all the attributes. This is a work in progress. I'm just showing you the glimpse of it. So we are trying to make the data collection in such a way that we can have a information that we can be, each toilet can then have a, you know, certain attributes with it. What we did is that we took the map from the Yamuna Action Plan, which is on the website, which is on the Yamuna Action Plan website, and then digitized it. And I'm just doing right now for one small zone in Karol Bagh. That's what we have been doing. And then we are helping this NGO to figure it out, whether it really makes for them, you know, how do they control their revenue and expenditure. And what we found is that they are really breaking even, you know, they are making actually profits right now. basically, I think some of the things that I wanted to talk to you about is that right now the information is available more on a quantitative basis and not on a spatial basis. And I would really like to insist on this, that until and unless we have a spatial data, it is very difficult to take certain decisions, technological decisions, financial decisions, and also policy level decisions. And that information has to be there, and it is with all the institutions. But how much of you put it into the public domain is the issue. Thank you.